Hi guys.
One,
I want to say I got new piercings. I'm going to be doing a video about these, and then like maybe the progress healing for like the first week. So for anyone watching, yes, these are new. I got them done today. Also, do you want to announce the winner of the...
We'll wait. Okay, so... first off, I want to say to all the Xbox users out there, if you, like, constantly run your Xbox, if it's constantly on like ours is, you may want to restart your system because there is an update.
It is pretty nice.
They included Beam. They completely reconfigured the home. One feature that I like is that when you hit your guide button, it doesn't take you back to home. It opens up the guide.
I do that all the time.
It opens up the guide just like it did on the 360.
Yeah.
So I'm loving it. I love how they set up the guide. And you can get to your home from the guide. So I love that they did that. It's so much easier for me because I play the 360 a lot. So
yeah. And when I played the X1, since I've kind of migrated more towards the X1, I got used to the 360 pushing that guide button. So Matt kind of laughs at me whenever my phone's vibrating for some reason. Matt laughs at me because I push the guide button expecting the guide thing to come up, and it takes me home, and I'm like, crap, what did I do? Please don't let me die. You know? So that was pretty
cool.
And
I've done that quite a bit, especially with, like, the backwards compatibility, because that's mainly all I've been playing on the X1 is backwards compatibility titles. I don't feel like turning on the 360. Recently I've been playing Bioshock 2, and I keep forgetting that I'm on the X1, so I go to bring up the guide, and it goes home. It's like, oh, shit. I keep forgetting the shortcut to bring up the
360 guide. Yeah, he hits it, and he's like, oh, shit. That's its exact expression. It was funny.
Anyways, they have done the March update. It actually hit yesterday. We didn't update ours until today.
It was a pretty quick update.
It updated because we turned it off before we left the
house.
Yeah,
but still.
So, the main reason that we're doing
this... Part of the main reason
is... I'm not sure if many of you have seen this. This is the...
Didn't we do a tasting on
Black
this before?
Label. I'm not sure if we have or not.
I can't
This
remember.
One has been out for a while. It came out shortly after they started doing the...
Yeah.
The contest between Baja Blast and Pitch Black.
Yeah.
The Black Label, it tastes very similar to the Pitch Black.
And to me, it tastes more like Voltage.
It tastes more like the Pitch Black to me. It has more of a grape taste to it.
And for me, I taste more of the berry.
Yeah.
It says it's a crafted dark berry. So, I mean, like, you know, Pitch Black and Voltage are similar sodas. It's just Voltage is more berry, while Pitch Black was more of the cherry?
Pitch Black is grape.
Grape, sorry. Why am I wanting to say cherry? I don't know. Because probably berry, cherry, you know.
Yeah.
But, yeah, Pitch Black is more grape, which I don't like, so I don't really care for Pitch Black. Voltage is more berry, so I prefer that. The Blackout right here tastes more like...
Black Label
tastes more... Blackout is a soda, isn't it? One of their sodas. Mountain Dew? Blackout?
Whiteout.
I don't...
You're getting everything mixed up.
Yes, I am. I'm still on that piercing high, okay? I got pierced like an hour ago, so yeah.
We found... we found more. So, they also have a white label, which we're going to taste... This is a crafted tropical citrus.
It kind of sounds like they're white out.
It says mysteriously exotic dew.
I'm kind of hoping it'll taste like coconut.
Like, on the black label, it says Deeper, Darker Dew. On the white label, it's Mysteriously Exotic.
When we taste these, I want to take a sip first since I have new piercings. I'm paranoid. Does it smell like coconut? Sorry.
It kind of smells like their white out.
It does.
If you've had their white out, that's kind of like a... That's kind of a grapefruit.
That burned. I haven't drunk anything since I got these pierced, so wait. I gotta, like, go back to how I used to drink when I had these freshly done. It tastes like grapefruit.
Yeah, it tastes like the white out. So if you've had the white out, that's pretty much what this tastes like. Not bad.
I like it.
It's kind of like...
It's like softer.
Yeah.
It's not as much of a heart. Because white out kind of makes me think of that squirt.
Yeah, that's exactly what they're going for, I think.
But this is like a more mellow. It's not a harsh grapefruit. It's like just like... It's kind of like the similar acidity to lemonade, but with grapefruit.
Yeah.
That's what it kind of makes me think of. Like a sweet, like a smooth lemonade, not the tart, tangy lemonade. Yeah. It's like the sweet, smooth lemonade.
Yeah, it's kind of like a grapefruit lemonade, but it's like really smooth.
It's not overly tart or tangy. It really burned on the inside. Well, not really burned. It just like tingled the inside.
They have a third one.
I'm excited for this one.
Green label. And this one says, Curiously Daring Dew. It is a crafted green apple kiwi.
That sounds like such a good combination.
Smells good.
Ooh, that smells like that green apple Smirnoff, kind of. I like that. That, like, the carbonation feels so weird inside. I like that. That's nice. Oh, yeah,
that's a good one.
A lot of times,
it's very hit and miss with apple soda.
Mm-hmm.
But this one nailed it.
The kiwi really complements that apple. It kind of tastes like sour apple with the best parts of strawberry kiwi. You know how strawberry kiwi strawberry kiwi is another hit or miss for me because a lot of times they put too much strawberry and it just tastes like you're just drinking just straight up strawberry. I like it when it's more on the kiwi side. I guess, you know, I just like the kiwi. But, you don't really straight up taste the kiwi. It's kind of like, it rounds out the fruity flavor.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like how espresso does with chocolate. You don't really taste the espresso, but it kicks up that chocolate flavor. You know what I mean? So that tastes
pretty good. So yeah, this one is really good. It's actually original. I don't remember them having anything out similar to this.
Even in the weird random sodas that we look at, there's nothing like that. There's not a green apple kiwi. That's like a completely new.
I think that Mountain Dew may have done an apple soda before, but I think it was like only in one area and very limited, like product testing. Because I like to look up their stuff every once in a while, see like what they've put out, and this is like, for me, this is brand new. I've never seen them put anything out like this with apple or so
I think definitely, that's my favorite.
Definitely, I highly suggest that one.
I really liked it.
I still like the black label. We didn't taste that one because we've already had it. We've already had that one.
Saving that for later.
Yeah, I'm going to save it for later. But it's been out since last year, so.
Was it last year?
Yeah, but it's one of my favorites, so I had to get it. I say out of the three, the green label is really good, but I probably have to say black label is still my favorite. with Green Label being a very close second. White Label does come in third.
With me, the Green Label and the White Label are kind of tied for me. I think Green Label is top because it's such a unique flavor, but I absolutely love grapefruit juice, grapefruit soda, grapefruit. I love it. So, like, that is, like, a really good one for me. But I'm also obsessed with green apple and all that, too. So, I love them both. But do we have a straw?
I think we might have some straws.
I'll have to look. I'm thirsty and I need a straw.
Is there anything that you were wanting to talk about?
We gotta announce the winner. We were very late with this, with announcing the winner of the little try not to knock things over. We were very late with announcing the winner of the little black cat Tsum Tsum. Mainly, I don't know about Matt, but I kind of forgot what day it was. It's surprising to me that it's like, thank you. It's surprising. Oh, you got a yellow. It matches. It surprises me that it's like the 30th of the third month in the year already. Like, Saturday is April 1st. That's kind of like crazy to me. It really is. So, I forgot what day of the week it was. And it's just been kind of hectic here. So, we are announcing the winner a bit late. The winner. I'm knocking everything over. I think only one person entered.
Double check.
Yeah, I'll double check. I believe they commented twice on the video. Like, one after the other. While I bring
that up. They might have been waiting for it to send, and it actually sent twice.
Well, it was two separate video, or comments, but either way.
Yeah, it does that sometimes.
Yeah, just one person. It was, like, right after, like, within seconds.
Okay, two different...
Yeah, two different comments.
Comments, okay.
But, the username is cute Kawaii... Why am I wanting to say Hawaii?
Kawaii?
I feel like I can't talk. Like, these feel so weird to talk. Cute... I used to be able to say this word. It's like kawaii. It's like cute. But, don't know if you could see that. Cute, kawaii. I will send you a message on, I almost said Facebook. On YouTube, you have, what do you say, 72 hours to reply? 72 hours. It is right now 5:47 p.m. California, which I think is Pacific time. Pacific? It is the 30th, so by the... I'm going to say midnight on Sunday.
No worries.
Midnight on Sunday, you have to reply. If you are under 18, we need verbal consent from a legal... parent or guardian, because we will need your address to ship out the little Tsum Tsum. Also, I'm still on the piercing high, so my brain is like, I cannot remember what I was going to say.
I don't know what you're gonna say either.
I don't know. If you don't reply within 72 hours, we will give this to my mother. It hurts to laugh. Mom made me laugh, like, really big and, like, kind of pulled a little bit. It feels like I have a very sore muscle, which I guess I do. It just had two needles shoved through it. I believe that's all for this video. I might, like, right after this, do my experience with the Dahlia piercings. So, right after we shut this off, I might start recording that, since I want to talk about it while it's fresh in my head. Was there anything you wanted to talk about?
They have, if you missed it, they have announced Destiny 2. They dropped the first trailer and the release date. And it is up for pre-order. If you go digital, there's 3 versions that you can get. If you're going physical copy, they just have the standard right now. So, but it is a September release date, if I remember correctly.
2017?
This year, yeah.
Oh, wow.
It'll be a September release date. I haven't watched the trailer for it yet because I'm still behind on the rest of the expansions and everything. So, the update. It looks like a lot of games on the X1 have gotten updates.
Didn't new South Park game release?
Actually, I have not checked that yet.
I thought you did.
South Park, the Fractured Butthole should...
Butthole?
should be out either today or tomorrow. I'm not sure if they pushed it back. I haven't heard, any news about it.
I'm looking it up.
But it should be out.
But then, if not today or yesterday, then...
No, it's either today or tomorrow.
Okay. I'm gonna look that up right now. It's, the Fractured Butthole.
Mm-hmm. I've been, keeping track on a few sites that I look at for Xbox news and everything, and I haven't seen anything about the new South Park game being released, so...
It says right here, the Fractured Butthole's release date has been pushed again, likely to late 2017. That kind of sucks, because it was supposed to release at the end of this month.
It's supposed to release today or tomorrow. The other thing that we can do... You got your controller over there?
Yes. It says... TFBW's planned December 6, 2016 got delayed until early 2017, and now it's looking like we might have to wait even longer. The official TFBW pre-order page states the game will be available by or on December 31st, 2017, but reports say that the game may have been pushed to as late as March 2018. The Stick of Truth was also notably delayed, and the end product was worth the extra wait, so hopefully Stone Parker and company are making the most of the prolonged development time, which sucks. I was absolutely looking forward to playing that.
Yeah, they just changed the available date on the pre-order, saying they pushed it all the way back just for the pre-order. It's saying December 30th, so it's pretty much, it's coming out this year, we just don't know when.
Yeah, they're taking they're just extra development time.
Because the last time I looked at the pre-order page, it said that it would be the 30th of March.
Yeah, and that was just last Sunday that you looked at it? It was a few days ago.
Yeah, it was either last week or a couple weeks ago, something like that.
I'm bummed about that because I was really looking forward to playing that.
Yeah, I was getting psyched up about the game too because we just watched the Coon and Friends episodes. But
I think that's all for me.
Oh, Far Cry 3 is backwards compatible now, if you haven't heard or seen yet.
For some reason, in my mind, whenever you were saying Far Cry, I was thinking Fallout.
WWE 2K17 is free to play all weekend for gold members. So if you're a wrestling fan, you can play all modes online story mode, whatever else they give you. You can play all modes until Monday. And then, I believe the last bit, Prey dropped a new trailer. I still haven't checked that one out. I want to. It's showing, powers, so I'm wanting to see that one. And also, Star Wars Battlefront 2, first look will be coming in mid-April, so it's coming up pretty fast to where we get our first look at Battlefront 2. And then, of course, we're a quarter through the year already, so we are pretty much halfway to E3. That's coming June,
17th?
I think 17th.
17th through the
20th. Or no, 13th.
13th There's, through the 17th.
Yeah, 13th through the 17th, I believe.
I got the 17th right.
So, yeah, I'm still so pumped about it. It's getting closer and closer. I'm getting really excited about E3. Yeah, I'm kind of out of it right now, so.
Not as out of it as I am. I'm still on that piercing high. I freaking love that shit right there. Nothing gets you higher than a freaking needle shoved through your skin. I love it. That's all for me. I said that like 5 times now. That's all for him.
I don't have anything, like nothing's really coming to me.
It'll probably come to him as soon as we shut off the video, like everything else.
Loot Crate. We did get the Andromeda, the Mass Effect Andromeda box. It will ship out in June. So if you ordered that, it's a one-off crate. It is limited edition. So it's
wasn't there an incentive to get?
I'm not. Box? Well, that would probably be over by now.
Oh.
And I'm not sure if we got it. They did have a little incentive, like a to order it early. I'm not sure if we were able to get it in time. It was very limited supplies, and by now you wouldn't be able to get it. But it was an extra pin.
Wasn't it like gold or something? We had a picture somewhere.
No, it wasn't gold, but it was
looked gold.
It was an Andromeda Initiative pin. It was gorgeous. And I'm really hoping that we ordered in time to get it. Because I would love to have it. I doubt that they would have any more by now. But you can still order the box. If you are a huge Mass Effect fan, you can still order it. This is a one-off box. Limited edition, just like the Gears of War one. One-off box, but those ship in June, so we will have a video for that in June, as well as probably the next Halo crate.
Yeah, it might be.
They might come around the same time. So
we also may. I mean, we were talking about it. My mom gets Waffles and the Kitties a Kitnip box. A Loot Crate has a Loot Petware, which I kind of wish they catered, like they also did for kitties. It's for dogs.
It's mainly catered for dogs.
Yeah, but I would still, like, they have the size small and extra small, which would fit Waffles and stuff, so it would be kind of cute to get him some Loot gear and all that. I'm also considering Owl Crate. Yeah, I'm also considering that because I'm a major book nerd. Can't tell since Matt took over my bookshelf. But if you like lean to the right, you can see my bookshelf. It's like in this vicinity right here. It's like right there.
He's got all my Infinity figures on it right now.
I occupy the bottom shelf with my books, along with various other places around the room. But so that might be more content we might be able to start doing. And I will also be giving updates on my Dahlia piercings, because it was a pain in the ass to find any information on these damn things, because apparently they are a very rare piercing. which I love. But anything else for you?
I can't think of anything.
Thank you for watching.
Bye.